Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So back to the bread and butter. Feels like a while since we've done any of these reviews. We've been a lot more focused on some of the teaching and the technical breakdowns recently. So see if we can remember how to do this. Direct to consumer sub 70 irons in hand. Have you played these or seen these before?
I've seen them. I've seen them quite a bit on like Twitter and stuff. I see they've sponsored a couple guys on a few of the different like developmental tours.
Yep.
I've never personally tried them, mainly because I think they do have lefty options, but I've never seen somewhere where I can actually test them out.
Try them. Yeah, they do. They have a decent amount of lefty options. I mean, they would put a couple of the OEMs to shame with the lefty options that they do. They do a nice job with that. So this is kind of in the plear cavity line. Definitely a more compact head, replaces the 639. This is the 659 CB. You've got the pitching wedge there. They've sent us them in the black finish. It comes in a satin finish, comes in a tour raw finish as well. So, you know, obviously we'll rust a little over time. First thoughts on the shaping and sort of profile?
Yeah, the head shape's good. I mean, it's definitely something that it's not overly big or chunky, which is important for me to look down at an iron. So initial thoughts, it's pretty nice.
Got some kind of pretty cool detailing in the back around the milling and some of the marking of it. It definitely, they've not went for a kind of a polished, you know, finished look. They've kind of left it looking a little bit more, you know, rugged and edgy with some of the milling on the back of it, which I kind of like. Cool to see the sole, little V-sole on the bottom there. Moved the V-sole up a little bit. So not your kind of traditional Strixon V-sole, which sits in the middle of the sole. This one is in the kind of front third of the club. That's for a different type of player than the V-sole being in the middle. So interesting enough, but pretty cool.
Yeah, no, they look good. I think nice and simple looking, which is like important for a lot of people.
So you're going to hit these right-handed?
Yeah, we're going to try the righty swing. See if we can catch the middle and see how they feel.
Yeah, definitely. So nice components in here. Lamkin Crossline grip, Nippon Modus shaft. Guys, I think in a time when we're seeing such a struggle to get certain components, you know, as we know it's been in the golf industry for quite some time, you know, this is where I think companies like Sub 70 are going to have a real opportunity right now. Just the swell in the industry is significant. New golfers are coming back, golfers are returning to the game. New golfers are taking up for the first time. And it's $659 USD for an iron set. I mean, it's pretty compelling.
Yeah, looking at that for the price point, it's going to be hard to beat that for sure.
It really, really is. Let's see what that is from a set makeup standpoint. Okay, 654 is what we're at. So right-handed. So these are coming in 5 to wedge. That's your 5 to pitch and wedge sort of price point. So on the specs, 5 iron goes down to 25 degrees, so not too bad. Most people are probably going to go 4 iron on a player's cavity set, so it does add a little bit more to the price. It pops up to another $109. Yeah. Pretty good going.
Yeah, reasonable for sure.
Yeah, gives you your shaft option, grip option, and a little ferrule upgrade option, which is
all in the details.
Fancy. All right, let's hit a few of the wedges. You comfortable at 130? Is that
yeah,
is that
I'd
right?
say 130 with the right-handed pitching wedge is pretty stock, okay. We'll call it.
It's ridiculous.
135, actually.
135. You're finding out your yardages with the righty swing. That's impressive. Okay, a couple more. Sounded good.
Yeah,
sounded
like caught the middle. Nice, felt good.
Nice solid strike.
It's a good one to start to kind of catch one in the middle. Might switch to right-handed.
You've said this to me more than one time in the past. Like you feel like if you practice righty, you could probably give yourself a run.
Yeah, no, I could. Not even catching those dead middle either.
Yeah.
Feel pretty good, like they're coming off still. And
they sound like they're in a better part of the head than that measurement is showing us anyway.
Yeah.
See a couple more. Sounded better.
Yeah, definitely a better strike on that one. Got a little stuck underneath it, but
it's pretty good though.
Pretty middle, like I hit the same spot pretty much every time. It's a little in the heel, but
yeah, higher up the head, so you would have definitely felt a little bit more of a clean contact. Okay, so for somebody who does not play the game that side of the golf ball, that's three pretty perfect swings.
Yep.
Okay, let's swap you into the 7. So loft here at 32. So very, very standard in terms of what we're seeing from the player cavity irons these days. The best ones in the class, the T100Ss, the ZX7s, exact same lofts as these guys.
Yeah, I think I really like the look of the 7-iron as well. There's not a lot of offset on that, yeah. Which I really like.
And there's a little in the wedge, isn't there?
I found a little bit. Yeah, I would say that's the only little knock on that for me personally. Me too, yeah. I don't like to see a lot of offset. I know some people it doesn't bother, but for me, I like to have minimal offset. And looking down at the 7-iron, it's a little bit more of what I'd like to see in an iron.
Definitely agree. Phenomenal. Dude, they sound great.
Yeah, they actually feel really good. They're quite soft off the face. I think I'm favoring the heel side, which you wouldn't maybe be able to tell with these flights, but
no,
it's feels pretty good.
Flusher. Do it. Pretty good.
Yeah.
Just loving that little heel strike.
It's a little too close to the heel to where we would probably want it, but
a little flirty.
To be honest, if it's getting these results off the heel, I'm not upset about it. Okay, I'm gonna try to get a little toey on this one.
Okay. That's good. That's a great flight.
Yeah. They feel really good.
Yeah, I was gonna ask if you thought that, like, you know, is 170 gonna be, like, you're going to be able to get it there? I mean, it's plenty to get it there.
Yeah, I feel like I could go a little harder at it too. I think there's a little bit more on the tank there.
Okay, give me one more, but I love the apex, love the angle of descent. I mean, this would be your righty gamer set for sure. You'd have no issues. Awesome.
That was more speed in that one, but definitely... loving the heel.
It's just in there, it's okay. Well, they're forgiven, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Very forgiven. You know, the people who follow you on the channel, do you think this is a type of club that the demographic that are playing golf or coming back to golf now, is this the type of thing that's cool, like a blacked out head, murdered out, you know, all that sort of stuff, and at half the price pretty much?
Yeah, I think for there's a lot of people that have a budget, obviously. Can't shell over $2,000 for a set of irons. Yeah. So having an option that you can still have something that looks like a kind of a big OEM iron, but for a fraction of the price that feels this kind of good, it's a great option. I would definitely start suggesting as an option.
That is a route to go. There's no doubt about that. I mean, this has attributes of, I mean, scary how close it has the attributes of some of our favorite irons over the last, call it, you know, probably 7-8 years. The way the sole's designed, the way the back is designed, the way the mass is distributed. I mean, if you're budget conscious, why wouldn't you?
Yeah, 100%. And again, for me, the top address, that's all I really care. I don't really care what it looks like sitting in my bag. As long as it's sitting there, makes me feel like I can hit a good golf shot from it when I'm standing at it. That's all I need. And that's something that these kind of offer. So. Yeah.
Well, looking, I mean, you as a golfer, the right-handed version of you and the way you play the game, I can see why a stock set is 5-to-wedge, because, you know, 7-iron spinning low 5,000s, when we get to this 4-iron, it's going to be a little bit kind of flat, and, you know, these great apex numbers we were seeing and angles of descent, you're likely to lose a little bit of that. So let's dive into the 4 and see how tough that is. All right, 4-iron. Little pocket cavity in there. See that in the back of that? There's a little sneaky... little sneaky forgiveness.
There we go.
That doesn't have... You know, that's like a progressive design, so... again, a lot of the irons that we like in this category have those sorts of, you know, CG adjustments to them, bringing the CG further down, higher launch, less spin, easier to kind of make sure we retain that distance. Move the green back to 215 here. So it's going to take a good poke to get it there.
Yeah. Again, 4-iron looks-wise at address, looks really good.
Mm-hmm.
See if we can put a good swing on one here.
There she is.
Overcooked it a bit.
Coming in like a scalded cat.
Like a 230 right-handed 4-iron.
Yeah, and that's what I kind of thought. Like, coming into like 3-wood territory numbers there. 13-6 launch, 3,000 spin. Kind of lost the kind of control as it comes in. So we do lose the peak. We've dropped about 10 degrees in descent. So that's where, as I say, I can see exactly why this is a 5-to-wedge set.
Yeah, definitely.
A ton of sense. So for you or the player who has that kind of flight, you know, probably a hybrid at this point would be quite nice.
Yeah, I agree. I think, I mean, a four iron to get up into the air to land it on a green is going to be pretty tough if it's coming in like that. So definitely.
Sound great. Sounds really, really well hit.
I'll try to hit a little higher one here and just see if we can launch one.
Oh, beauty. Just hung it open.
Yeah, just a little open.
A little bit more. Launching that one. 15.9 with more spin. So it's not possible that we're going to, you know, maybe be functional with the four iron. So. That's nice. Two bills on the fly.
I hit that one pretty clean.
Here she comes. I mean, that's pretty impressive. Hitting the green 215 out, 219 total. That was pretty flush.
Yeah, I hit that one. I mean, again, I'm living a little bit in the heel, but it still feels pretty good. So imagine how good it feels in the center.
Yeah, so kind of as expected from a dispersion standpoint, it was a little bit bigger. You know, you were kind of hugging it down the right-hand side or turning it over. Just the path being a little into out. That's really all it is. So you're fairly shallow in your angle of attack and just a little inside out with the push draw. But I tell you what, you could do worse.
No,
you
for
could
sure.
Do a lot worse, I mean, than a set of those.
I think if I practiced a little bit more with the four iron and got that attack angle a little bit more down and not so trying to help it up in the air, it would be a little easier. But they feel really good.
They sound you know, nice and soft.
Definitely soft.
Yeah, we're using a Bridgestone Tour B XS, so it is a softer golf ball and a golf ball that we thought would complement kind of the ball flight for Mac here, just because he does tend to get a little bit into out and obviously spin rate drops, so trying to kind of keep a little bit of spin on there. So I really, honestly, I'm pretty impressed with those.
Yeah, no, they felt great.
Great value. Okay, guys, we do continue to test these products, not for our benefit because we don't sell them, but for your benefit because we do think they're a quality offering. There's lots of different ways to buy golf clubs now. You can be fit by us, you can be fit by big box stores, you can buy online if that's where you feel that the value comes from, but there's just more options than ever before, and that's what we love about it. So testing these is just giving you guys more information and arming you with the right knowledge when you do make a decision. If, you know, four to pitch and wedge and $763 is in your budget and kind of 1500 is not, you know, which is kind of probably a full custom set of irons these days, head, shafts and grips, then this is a phenomenal option. So, you know, hopefully gives you guys something to think about when it comes to purchasing. Stay tuned for more. We do have more direct to consumer products coming. Big shout out to all those guys for the quality work they're doing. I think it's really cool to see. So stay tuned for more. We'll see you again soon.